Hello aspirants, today is December 24, 2019 and I am Shubhangini Dubey. We are always coming up with the Approach 365 course. This is the Daily Current Affairs course and today we are going to discuss the topics. Topics are as follows, and the first topic is Mountain Gorillas, the second topic is Mission Shat Pratishat, the third one is Kundan Kulam Nuclear Power Plant, the fourth one is Winter Solstice, the fifth one is Minority Rights in India. Then there is the Peregrine Falcon. Then there is E-Masiha. Then Hunar Hearts. Then the last two topics are European Council and the Nagpur Resolution. Okay. So beginning with the topics, first is Mountain Gorilla. Okay. So guys, I want to tell you something about Mountain Gorillas because there are so many international organizations who are working to save these Mountain Gorillas. Okay. So there is a big, foundations are there. Okay. In Rwanda, there are so many gorillas are there in which in the international level, people are conserving them. Okay. So in a new survey of Mountain Gorillas, and then increase it has revealed that the increase in the populations have their population have been increased. Okay, so the team conducted the survey in the Bavindi Sarambevi ecosystem straddling the border between Uganda and the Democratic Republic of Congo. Okay, so this was the team, and the survey was done in the Bavindi Sarambevi ecosystem. Okay, and it is between the Uganda and the Democratic Republic of the Congo. Okay, so mountain gorilla live in the mountains of Democratic Republic of Congo, Rwanda and Uganda. So these are the places in which mountain gorillas live. Okay, so it's in the Africa. Okay, and they live at the altitude of approximately 8,000 to 13,000 feet. Okay, and they are unique to a small section of Central Africa. And they are only found in the Virunga Massif, which is comprised of three parks that are found in the countries of Rwanda, Uganda, and Democratic Republic of Congo. Okay, so not just the government of this Africa, but even some organizations from Africa are also helping. Okay, if you have listened to the name of Ellen DeGeneres, okay, she's a celebrity in United States and she's doing a great job to save the mountain gorillas. She's also having a fund. She's raising fund because to save these mountain gorillas. Okay, so in Rwanda, there is the Volcanoes National Park. And in Uganda, it is the Maghinga National Park. And in the Democratic Republic of Congo, Virunga National Park are there. And in the Bavindi, Impenetrable National Park is in Uganda. These are the places where the mountain gorillas have been found. Okay, so the mountain gorillas have been now have been downlisted to endangered from critically endangered in the IUCN Red List of Threatened Species. Okay, so first earlier it was in the critically endangered, but now it has been downlisted. So somehow it's some way it is a good news because these are for a long time it has been in the critically endangered species, but now it is in the endangered species. Okay, so this is about the mountain gorillas. Then the next topic is Mission Shat Pratishat. Okay, so it is about the Punjab Education Department. They have recently launched this Mission Shat Pratishat. Okay, so basically it aims to achieve 100% result in class 5th, 8th, 10th and 12th of government school. Okay, so it is for the government school and they want 100% result. So the department has coined a slogan, Asambhav nu sambhav banaiye shat pratishat natija laiye. Okay, so this is the slogan for the Punjab Education Department under the Mission Shat Pratishat. Okay, so which means that make impossible possible and secure 100% result. Okay, so WhatsApp group of teachers, students and parents of by different subject teachers have been formed, and they will it is to ensure the proper coordination as well as sharing of good practices. Okay, so the teacher and students are being sensitized about the structure of the question papers through EduSat. Okay, so education satellite, with the help of education satellite, question teachers and students are being sensitized, and somehow they are teachers and students are all the teachers and students are getting motivation from it so that 100% result can be there. Okay, and model question papers are also there. They have been also prepared for every subject and students are motivated to solve them. Okay, so the government school teacher have voluntarily been taken extra classes not only during working days but also on Sundays and the holidays. Okay, so this is about the Mission Shat Pratishat. So it is in Punjab. Asambhav nu sambhav banaiye shat pratishat nati jalaiye. Then another topic is Kundan Kulam Nuclear Power Plant. Okay, so recently it is the Moscow based news. Okay, so the Moscow based Rosatom State Corporation Engineering Division, okay, installed a core melt localized device or cold catcher at Unit 3 of Kundankulam Nuclear Power Plant, okay. So, this is a power plant, okay, and it is the first, India's first nuclear plant which is used in the pressurized water reactor technology, okay. So, this technology has been used by this power plant, okay, and it is the first nuclear plant which is using this technology, that means pressurized water reactor. So, the existing nuclear power plant in India used pressurized heavy water reactor or boiling water reactor technology. Okay, so this is the difference between the other reactors and the Kundankulam nuclear power plant. In other nuclear power plant, they are using the pressurized heavy water reactor or the boiling water reactor. But here they are using the pressurized water reactor. Okay, coal catcher. Now, what is coal catcher? Okay, which they have installed. So, it is a device. And it is designed basically to localize and cool the molten core material in case of meltdown accident. So, if there is any meltdown accident, so it just cool and localize the molten core. Okay, so it is the core catcher. And molten core material, it is a lava-like material. Okay, just like which is comes from the volcano, the lava. Okay, so molten core material, it is a lava-like material that get formed in the core of a nuclear reactor in the event of meltdown accident. Okay, so if there is any meltdown accident, then in the core, a lava-like material is formed and to cool it down, coal catcher is there. Okay, so this is about this news. Okay, Kundankulam nuclear power plant. And more about it, such an incident occurs when the nuclear fusion reaction taking place inside a reactor. Okay, so there are two type of reactions. One is fusion reaction and another one is fission reaction. So basically it happens because of the fission reaction. Okay, so accident occur because of the fission reaction and place inside a reactor is not sufficient because the buildup of the heat causes fuel rods to melt down. And because of that lava-like structure, it also melt down the rods. Okay, so and that's why catcher... core catcher has been installed. Okay, so in the past, a meltdown accident have been occurred at Chernobyl in Russia in 1986 and the Fukushima in Japan in 2011. So in the nuclear reactor in these two countries, in Russia and in Japan, this meltdown accident happened, and that is the reason such precautions has been taken. Okay, so the coal catcher is installed at the bottom of a nuclear station protective shell, and it is designed to save as well as exude radioactive emission in the environment in case of a serious accident. So basically core catcher is there. From the name itself, sometime it's clear that in core there is a lava like structure. Okay, so when this lava like structure melts down everything, so it catches. So that's why it is named as the core catcher. Okay, so in 2011, the device was first installed in the Tianwen nuclear power plant in China, which is of Russian design. Okay, so this is about the, it was first installed in China. Okay, and then now other nuclear power plants are also using it. Okay, so it's a good thing, it's a safe thing. Okay, moving on to the next topic, winter solstice. Okay, so winter, most of the, I think winter is a favorite season of most of the people. Okay, so December 22. Okay, so before few days, sorry, because there are so many news, so sometimes we skip some news. Okay, so we added another lectures. Okay, so December 22, it is the winter solstice. Okay, and it is the shortest day of the year in the northern hemisphere. Okay, so in the northern hemisphere, December 22 is known as winter solstice, and it is the shortest day. So in Delhi, the south rose at 7.9 a.m. and will set at 5.29 p.m. Make the day 10 hours, 19 minutes and 17 hours long. Okay, so usually there is a day of 12 hours. Okay, so in summers it is long. But in winter solstice, it is the shortest day on the date of December 22. Okay, now in the southern hemisphere, conversely, it is the summer solstice. Okay, so in places like Australia, New Zealand or South Africa, December 22 is the year's longest day. Okay, so this is the beauty of this earth. Okay, somewhere it is the shortest day in the northern hemisphere because winters are there. It is opposite in the southern hemisphere. Okay, so just like winter solstice is there in the northern hemisphere, it is the summer solstice in the southern hemisphere. Okay, so in New Zealand, South Africa, it is the longest day. Okay, so the earth axis of rotation is tilted at the angle of 23.5 degree away from the perpendicular. Okay, so on the equator, day and night are equal. The closer one moves towards the pole and the more extreme the variations. Okay, so this is about the winter solstice and the summer solstice. Okay, so I think many of you already know that during the Christmas, most of the areas of the earth is having winter season, but in countries like Australia, New Zealand, and South Africa, the Christmas falls in their summer season. Okay, so because of this, northern and southern hemispheres. Moving on to the next topic, minorities' rights in India. Okay, so it is observed on 18th December in India. Okay, so before a few days only. And the aim of this day is to keep reminding the right of minorities and basically to educate people about it. Okay, so it focuses on the religious harmony, respect, and better understanding of all minority communities in India. Okay, and it is celebrated by the National Commission for Minorities. So we are already having a National Commission for Minorities. And Article 29-30. 358-350B, they have afforded protection to the minorities in the country. Okay, so in the Constitution of India itself, it is written. So the framer of the Constitution were quite conscious of the importance of these provisions, because these provisions are very important, because there are people who are minority and they must be treated equally. Okay, so Union Government set up the National Commission for Minority, which was made under the Commission for Minority Act 1992. So in 1992, this commission was formed, and the minorities of India include Muslim, Sikh, Christian, Buddhist, Zoroastrians, that means Parsis, and the Jains. Okay, so these are the minority in India, and Jain have been notified as minority community through a notification in 2014. Okay, so they have given the minority status in 2014. Okay, before few years. Another topic is peregrine falcon. Okay, so what it is? So basically, it is a raptor and it live on a continent except Antarctica. Okay, so it is a raptor and they prefer wide open spaces and thrive near coast, which shore birds are common, but they can be found. Raptor means it is a kind of bird. Okay, and they live in all continents except Antarctica, maybe because of the vegetation and climate there. Okay, so but they can be found everywhere from tundra to deserts. Okay, so peregrine falcon, it is a kind of bird, a raptor, which can be found in every continent from tundra to desert except Antarctica. Its population were a steep decline during the mid-20th century in the United States. It became an endangered species. Okay, so in mid-20th century, it became an endangered species in the United States. And in the IUCN list, in the International Union Conservation List, it is least concerned in its red list of threatened species. Okay, so not that much there, because it is already being there. Okay, so as per the recent study, it has fostered vision in the animal kingdom and registered nearly 130 frames per second. Okay, so one of the fastest vision is there in the animal kingdom. Okay, so this is about the peregrine falcon. Then another topic is e-mashiha. Okay, so it is it is about the India have become the first country in the entire world, and it has done a huge good job. That means it has done entire Hajj 2020 process 100% digital. Okay, so now online application, e-visa, Hajj mobile app, e-mashiha, health facility, e-luggage pre-tagging, all have been provided to Indian Muslim which are going for the Hajj. Okay, so e-mashiha, it is the e-medical assistance system for Indian pilgrimage across. Okay, so it is the full form of the e-mashiha, and it is an online system to create and maintain the complete health database of Indian pilgrims to deal any emergency in Makkah Madina. Okay, so it is to help and supporting the Muslims. Okay, so the database contains doctor prescriptions, medical treatment, as well as medicine disbursals. Okay, so this is about the e-mashiha. Then there is the Hunar Haats. Okay, so what is Hunar Haat? It is an exhibition program organized by the Ministry of Minority Affairs to provide international market for master artisans of minority community to sell their products. Okay, so basically Hunar Haat, from the name itself, it is related to the skills. Okay, so exhibition of Ministry of Minority Affairs provided, and it provides training to master artisans, and training is also given to master artisans and culinary expert. Okay, and government is targeting to establish Hunar Haats in every state of India of the country in next 5 years. So within 5 years, every state will be having the Hunar Haats. Okay, another topic is European Council. So in previous lectures also we learned about the European Council, but why it's in news again? Because it has brought together the European Union leaders to set the European Union political agenda and represent the highest level of political cooperation between European countries. Okay, so basically European Union works like that, and it defines the European Union overall political direction and the priorities. So whatever priorities are there from the European Union, European Council look after it. Okay, so it's not one of the European Union legislation institutions, so it does not negotiate or adopt EU laws. Okay. And there are so many members, and out of it, there are 28 European Union member states, okay? And European Union Council President is there, and the President of European Commission is there in the European Council, okay? And Mr. Charles Michel of Belgium have been recently elected to the President of the European Council, and this is the reason this was in news, okay? So, Mr. Charles Michel of Belgium is the person who has been elected as the President of the European Council. The next topic is the Nagpur resolution. Okay, so this resolution, it has been adopted basically on improving public service delivery by the Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances. Okay, so a resolution have been adopted in order to improve the public service delivery. Okay, and delivery, that means that whatever grievances are there, so it can be done with a better service. Okay, so it will empower citizens by policy intervention for better service delivery. Okay, previously Shillong Declaration and Jammu Resolution have been adopted for good governance. So Nagpur Resolution is also for the good governance and the improving public serving delivery. Okay, so this is about the Nagpur Resolution. So aspirants, this was today's lecture, and if you want to download the PDF of it, just log into the link I have mentioned here, pluspromise.in. And you can download the PDFs of Approach 365 Daily Current Affairs. And we are also having the course. If you want to have the discussion, you can also enroll in that particular course. And from it's been 2 and 3 months, and we are already coming daily with the current affairs. And you just watch the videos, you will be finding the daily current affairs lectures of every day. Okay. So tomorrow again, we will come out with another video lecture. Thanks for watching.